Alright, salam alaikum and welcome to this first part of Let's Play Mount&Blade Warband. And in this Mount&Blade Warband, I would like to, this being my first Mount&Blade Warband video, I will be doing a campaign, of course. And I entitled this campaign Mount&Blade Warband, The Rise of the Ottoman Empire. Now, just as a head start warning, I'm not going to be starting off on day one. On the contrary, I've been playing this one campaign which has lasted like nearly 600 hours, and in effect, it has led me into 9 years of Mount&Blade Warband Calradia time in playing. As you can see, I'm precisely on the day 3400, so my character is heavily veteranized, he has a great army, all my companions are quite leveled up, and we're just rocking the world. So without further ado, we are going to go into this game. By the way, sorry if my voice isn't as hyper as it usually is. I'm trying to sound as hyped up as I possibly can, because I really am. Deep down inside, I just want to shout my lungs off, but it's kind of late at night, and I don't want to, you know, the Mr. and Mrs. are kind of like in snooze mode right now, and I really don't need to hear them bitching in the morning of how I was so loud, and oh god. So yeah, I'm not going to be like one of those guys who starts off on day one. No, I'm starting off on day 3400 where I am just all-powerful. I'm like a god, so to speak. So, here we are, the world of Calradia, in which three-quarters of it are under Sarranid rule, thanks to yours truly. Because there was a point where the Rodaks actually had an empire stretching all the way into Kudan and everything in between, but I single-handedly took each and every one of those fortresses down. As you can see, the Kyrgyz Khanate, the Kingdom of Aegirs, and the Nords have been absorbed within the Sarranid Sultanate. The poor Swadians are just down to their last castles. They're at war with the Rodaks, and the Rodaks are sort of a secondary world power, as they're, you know, kind of difficult to dislodge from their castles and whatnot. That, or I've chosen not to. So, as you can see, we're in the year 1266. It's been 9 years since the official campaign starting, and so yeah, let me just give you a background of what happened. I've spent like the first 2 years up until like 1759 in the deserts of the Sarranid world, just improving my relationships with the cities and whatnot. All the villages love me except the one, which is Hawa, and that was because I looted it accidentally when it had come under Rodak occupation. So, and I didn't know, because as you can see, it's like right at the border of the desert. I thought it was a Rodak city, but I mean village, but you know, that's okay, it's just one village. All the others just love me to death. So basically how it started off was, I remember I was just in the desert fighting desert bandits, training my Sarranid guards, you know, blah blah blah. I never used Mamelukes up until one day Sultan Hakim tells me to train some Mamelukes, and then I realized just how badass they were on the battlefield, and ever since then I've been like a Mameluke addict. So the first faction to fall was pretty much the Kyrgyz Khanate. They're like the first faction to always fall in any campaign, followed by the Vagars and then the Nords. And something pretty epic happened, as the Nords in their last days, they tried besieging Sargoth back with an army of 2,000, and with 250 men, with only 250 men, 110 of the Mamelukes, I raped the crap out of the Nords. It was a close battle, but we won. I gained so much renown. I had like literally a renown of 5,001. Unfortunately, I haven't experienced a battle of such magnitude since, and my renown has dropped considerably, but I still have a pretty large army. That was originally 270 or so, but now it's to 238. So without further ado, let's just make a quick backdrop of my character. Mehmood il Ghazi Osmanliye, level 46 with a health of 80. As you can see, I have a power strike and iron flesh of 9. Basically, I could kill just about everything in Calradia in just one blow. I remember with a two-handed weapon, it was a saber, I believe, I dealt on